Welcome, all of you, wherever you are watching, to the Octagon Parish, a group of small villages with historic churches in the beautiful South Downs National Park near Chichester. My name is Lindsay Yates, the rector of the parish, and I am joined in this service by our honorary assistant priest, Will Adam, and by farmers from our local community. Today, on the first Sunday after the Epiphany, the church commemorates the baptism of Christ. But there is another ancient tradition for this time of year, where agricultural communities marked going back to work after the Christmas feast. On this Plough Sunday, we will be thinking about and praying for those who work on the land and who produce food in this and other communities. And in line with the old tradition, we will be blessing a plough and seed as our farmers prepare to break the ground and plant the seed this year. St. Paul writes this: "Those who sow bountifully will also reap bountifully." Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Give us the joy of your saving help, and sustain us with your life-giving Spirit. We have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we may give ourselves to the service of God. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. Let us confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins and restore you in his image, to the praise and glory of his name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the prophecy of Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. Here ends the lesson.
Reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus said, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not the life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, what will we eat, what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things, and indeed your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today. Here ends the reading.
Hello, my name is Will Adam, and I work alongside Lindsay here in the Octagon Parish. I don't know about you, but I'm finding life at the moment very uncertain. We all hope that this new year will be a year when the sickness, worry, and restrictions of the last year will fade. We hope for a future not only of getting back to some sort of normality, but to a better, new normal. But if the last year has taught us anything, it is that we are more often than not stuck with uncertainty and unpredictable change. We see good news and bad news in the fight against the pandemic. There is hope one day and sadness the next. So in such times, as Christians, it is more important than ever to hold on to two things, hope and confidence. The hope and the confidence that come not from ourselves, but from God. Where we are in the South Downs, not far from Chichester in West Sussex, we are never more than a few metres away from land that is farmed. Around our small villages there are fields and hillsides, some with cattle, many with sheep. There are vast tracts of arable land growing cereals and other crops. And mixed in with all this are the examples of modern, diverse farming. Horses, pheasant, llama, and even the occasional vineyard. Throughout the ages, those who work the land have lived with great uncertainty. There have been great advances over the years in the science and technology of agriculture, but as yet, nothing has allowed us to control the weather. We can improve the soil, or spoil it. We can match the crops or the livestock to the type of ground. But we cannot make the rain fall or the sun shine. My long years of taking summer weddings show that whilst it's more likely to be good weather in, say, July, it cannot be guaranteed. On Plough Sunday, we are still in the deepest days of winter. But we are in a new year. And as we look forward, we are looking forward to the days getting longer and warmer, to the ploughing of the land and the sowing of summer crops. We look forward to lambing and haymaking and harvest. And we look forward with hope, hope built on faith, faith in God who made all the creation, who loves it and who gives us what we need. Jesus knew the realities of agricultural life. You can hear that in his parables and sermons. And in today's gospel reading, we heard him referring to the plants and animals, the lilies of the field and the birds of the air. Do not worry, he says. Our Heavenly Father knows what we need. Do not worry. Now you might hear this and think, well, that's easier said than done. Worry is something that we all do. It's a natural consequence of uncertainty. If we cannot be sure what is going to happen, and if things not turning out well is one of the options, then worry is very easy to come by. If the rain and the snow talked about in our Old Testament reading come down from heaven, and rather than merely watering the earth, flood it, then those growing crops on that land will, of course, worry. But worry, as Jesus tells us, does not accomplish anything. Rather, we should strive for the kingdom of God and his righteousness. In doing so, we acknowledge that ultimately it is God who is in charge. And when we acknowledge the authority of God, then we can have that hope and that confidence that I spoke of earlier. The farmer knows that he or she needs the rain and the sun, and looking ahead from this point of the year, trusts with faith that these will come in the right quantities and at the right time. This is a challenge. And you don't know whether the year has been a good one until the crop is in the barn. But this is what Jesus invites us to do, to trust and to be confident in God's love and care for us. Here in the countryside, we know the harsh realities of failing crops and poor weather. Climate change has made what the scientists call extreme water events more common, be that too much or too little rain, or rain at the wrong time. But with each new year, there is the new hope of a new beginning and a good and fruitful year. Wherever we are, in city, town, or country, we stand at the beginning of a new year. Worry is easy. But let us all this new year hear again Jesus' words and trust in God who knows our needs. Let's face 2021 with confidence and hope for a better year, a healthier year, and a year where, together, we strive to make the kingdom of God visible in the world that he made.
Thank you.
we join together in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As we come to a time of prayer, the response to "May those who sow in tears" is "Reap with shouts of joy." May those who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. Let us pray. Let us pray to God, our Creator, who has given us the earth's goodness for our delight and entrusted it to our care and tenderness. For all those who live in captivity to debt, whose lives are cramped by fear, from which there is no turning, except through abundant harvest. Lord, we pray, may those who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. For all who depend on the earth for their daily food and fuel, whose forests are destroyed for the profit of a few. Lord, we pray, may those who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. For those who labour in poverty, are oppressed by unjust laws, are prevented from speaking the truth, and long for a harvest of justice, Lord, we pray. May those who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. For all who are captive to greed and waste and boredom, whose harvest joy is choked with things they do not need, Lord, we pray. May those who sow in tears reap with shouts of joy. Save us from all that holds us captive. Restore our vision, that our tongue may be filled with laughter and our tongue with songs of joy. Amen. Eternal Father, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, grant to us who are born again by water and the Spirit that we may be faithful to our calling as your adopted children. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I've come to visit one of the farmers in the parish to bless the plough.
I'm Chris Felton. We've been here since 1954. Farmers would fear at this time of year is lots of rain, floods, and also sudden frosts. A gradual frost is fine. I put my faith in God to bring us the right kind of weather, whether that's rain at the right time or sunshine at the right time. As my father would say, it's only been a good year when we got the crops harvested and in the shed.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation,
In your goodness, you have given us this seed to sow. In it, we perceive the promise of life, the wonders of your creative love. By your blessing, let this seed be for us a sign of your creative power, that in sowing and watering, tending and watching, we may see the miracle of growth and in due course reap a rich harvest. As this seed must die to give life, reveal to us the saving power of your Son, who died that we might live, and plant in us the good seed of your word. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for in your abundant care you have given us fertile land, rich soil, the seasons in their courses. You provide seed for sowing, water, light, and warmth, to bring forth the miracle of growth. You give us skill to work the land, to prepare and nourish it, that it may be fruitful. Bless all the labours of your servants. Bless the tools and machinery used in your service. By your blessing, let this plough be a sign of all that you promised to us. Prosper the work of our hands and provide abundant crops for your people to share. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
God speed the plough.
God speed the plough.
Grant favourable weather, temperate rains, and fruitful seasons, that there may be food and drink for all creatures. Hear us, good Lord. Bestow your blessing upon the lands and waters, and all who work upon them, to bring forth food and all things needful for your people. Hear us, good Lord. Prosper all who care for the earth, the water, and the air, that the riches of your creation may abound from age to age. Hear us, good Lord. May God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the source of all goodness and growth, pour his blessing upon all things created and upon you, his children, that you may use his gifts to his glory and the welfare of all peoples. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Tend the earth, care for God's good creation, and bring forth the fruits of righteousness. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.